Hi, Oswego Middle School 7th graders, parents, and guardians. This is Mrs. Fierro. Welcome to the Oswego Middle School orientation for 7th grade students and any new students that enrolled this summer for 2020. This is the Oswego Middle School.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Fierro again. We're going to begin our Google Slide presentation right now, so stay tuned. Welcome to our 2020-2021 7th grade and new student Oswego Middle School orientation. Keep in mind that in the Oswego City School District, our mission and vision includes graduating students who are fully prepared and life ready. Today, we will be introducing you to some key folks from the Oswego Middle School, such as myself, my assistant principal, the counselors, and so on. Throughout this Google Slide presentation, different people will pop in via video clip, introduce themselves, and tell you a little about themselves. We are also going to run our name and title across the bottom of the screen and our email if you need to approach us or get in touch at some point before school starts. Parents and guardians, we mailed home all of the paperwork that needs to be completed for your child to start 7th grade or 8th grade if they're new to our building. One of the forms is the email form. I do a lot of email blasts via our school messenger system, and in order to do an email blast, I need a current email address from each parent. Please be sure to print your email address so it's legible. For example, I know the difference between the ones and the L's, that kind of thing. And make plans to return these documents to us on September 8th if you're a 7th grader, or September 9th if you're a 9th grader. September 9th if you're an 8th grader. Times for the drop-off of this paperwork and pickup of textbooks were mailed home with your schedules. Parents, we also need you to complete the educational internet account with your student. Make sure you read through this carefully. You fill out all parts. There are a couple sections where we need to make sure that your child has put their initials next to it, or we will not be able to complete your child's educational internet account. Please fill in my name, Mary Beth Fierro, as the trainer, and the training date was August 2020. Remember, when we give your child this educational internet account, it's to use for school purposes only. If we find that non-school emails are being sent or non-school websites are being used or accessed, we will shut down the account. At this time, we're going to introduce one of our counselors.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Pearson, and I'm one of the counselors here at the middle school. I work primarily with 7th grade. And during the year, if you need to reach me, you can reach me at kpearson, P-E-A-R-S-O-N, at oswego.org. I look forward to working with all of you. Take care.
Thank you, Mrs. Pearson. Now a look at our virtual learning schedule for the Oswego Middle School for the fall of 2020. All students should be ready to go for their first class at 9 in the morning. Each class throughout the day is 1.5 hour long on the computer, and the expectation is that your child will be on class in a Google Meet live each one of the classes that are on their schedule. The only exceptions are study hall, structured study, and lunch. No need to sign in for those classes. We will be taking attendance for the day based on your child's attendance in the Google Meets. So this is different than last spring. Last spring, we were not taking attendance for the day based on Google Meets. This year we are. It is very important that your child log on beginning at 9 o'clock in the morning and be present for each one of their classes. At this time, we are introducing our second guidance counselor.
Hello, 7th graders. My name is Mr. Rogers, and I'm one of three school counselors here at Oswego Middle School. I'm headed into my 6th year working here, and I work with both 7th and 8th graders. I look forward to get to know you over the next 2 years.
This is Cooper. I'm the 8th grade guidance counselor, and welcome to Oswego Middle School. I look forward to meeting you, whether it be virtually or in person. If you need anything, just let me know. I can be reached at the below email address. Thank you.
Thank you, Cooper. Thank you, Mrs. Cooper. Just a reminder, Oswego Middle School students, parents, and guardians, it's important that you attend your Google Meets each and every day. If for some reason you miss a first or second period class, jump into your third period class or your fourth period class. It's important that you attend as many classes as possible, and the goal is always that you attend 100% of your classes. If your child misses more than 18 school days in a year, they are considered chronically absent. Their name falls on a list that New York State Ed puts out, and there are certain things that we need to do here at the middle school to help them improve their attendance rate. For every day of school, it takes up to 3 days to make up the work. Attendance at school is a priority. You are more likely to get better grades, develop healthy life habits, avoid dangerous behavior, and have a better chance of graduating from high school, which we want you all to do in 5 years with your class, or 4 years if you're an incoming eighth grader. So every school day counts. Another introduction now, our OMS school psychologist.
Welcome to Oswego Middle School. My name is Mrs. Baker, and I am the school psychologist here in the building. I oversee grades 7 and 8, so I get the good fortune of meeting every student in the school, hopefully. This year it may be virtually, but we're up to the challenge. So welcome to the middle school. We're happy to have you. We're here to meet your needs in whatever way we can. Have a great year, everyone.
Thank you, Mrs. Baker. Virtual learning. What is different about virtual learning and in-class learning? Not a lot, really. Expectations are similar. We need to make sure that you join your Google Meets on time, similar to being in class on time. If you could be in your Google Meet a minute or two ahead of time, that would be great. Please make sure that your video is on, your camera is on, but you are muted unless called on or you need to ask a question. Please respect others and be kind online. There is a chat option in Google Meets. Nothing inappropriate should be put in the chat, and nothing inappropriate should be said online. Cell phones should be off and away during the class. We don't want to see you looking at your cell phone. We don't want to hear the cell phones go off. We don't want to hear any music on the cell phones. They should be put away just like in class. Also, keep in mind that the Oswego City School District's code of conduct is in place at all times, as is the dress code. Please do not show up at your Google Meets with an inappropriate outfit on, inappropriate t-shirt, pajamas. Anything that would not be appropriate for the building should not be worn on a Google Meets. Any questions? You can always contact Mrs. Fierro directly, parents, guardians, or students. I'm open to suggestions. And another person that we are introducing, our school nurse.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mrs. Cheslock, the school nurse at the Oswego Middle School. I know things are going to be different this year, but I just wanted to assure you that I am a phone call or an email away to speak with you about any of your questions or concerns. Also, a reminder to parents, although your children are not attending school physically in the buildings this year, we are still obligated to follow New York State guidelines for immunizations and physical requirements. So please take the time to contact your healthcare providers and send in any required information. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Cheslock. Now, a couple of things that we want to talk about should we return to school in person this year, which fingers crossed we will be doing. Arrival procedures. If you are going to be eating breakfast at the middle school, you can enter the building at 7:15. If you're not eating breakfast, we don't let anyone who's a non-breakfast student until 7:25. No reason to arrive much earlier than that. If you're riding a bus, you'll be right on time, but if you're getting dropped off or walking, something like that, no reason to arrive much earlier than 7:25 because we don't let anyone in. No skateboards allowed on campus or on any school grounds. Bikes are allowed, and we do have a bike rack. If you want to ride your bike, please make sure that you are wearing a helmet. Dismissal procedures, our day ends at 2:30. If you are staying after school for a sport, you can report directly to Sports Study Hall, which is in our cafeteria. And our late bus runs at 3:20. If you just want to stay after school for extra help or something, we do have a late bus every day at 3:20. That is when we are back in session. We do discourage early pickups between 2 and 2:30. Our buses start to pull into the bus loop. It gets very busy. If you do need to pick your child up early, please be sure to send a note in with them and try to pick them up before 2 o'clock. And this is all if we return to school in person at some point this year. And I'm going to turn the mic over now to my assistant principal, Ms. Samantha Spaulding, who will introduce herself on video and narrate the last few slides of our Google Meets.
Thank you, Mrs. Fierro. Hello, everyone. I am Ms. Spaulding, the assistant principal at Oswego Middle School. Welcome to the Oswego Middle School's virtual orientation for this school year. Although school will begin differently this year than it has in years past, we are looking so forward to meeting each and every one of you. We're hopeful that we will be together at the Oswego Middle School in person soon. If you have any questions regarding technology, please reach out to me with those questions. I can be reached via my email address, which is below the screen, sspaldy@oswego.org. I am the point of contact for Oswego Middle School students and families regarding technology needs. I will return later during this orientation with some more information, but again, welcome everyone, especially our seventh graders and new students to Oswego Middle School family. Remember, once a buck, always a buck. Hi everyone, this is Ms. Spaulding again. So I would like to talk to you about some other important information regarding the Oswego Middle School. Parents, guardians, other people that may visit the middle school for a variety of reasons. I just want to go over our expectations and the procedures that we have in regards to that. So if you have a reason to visit the middle school, you must not visit if you're experiencing any signs of illness. We ask that you please stay home and just put in a call to the main office with any questions or concerns that you have, and perhaps we're able to address those over the phone. If visitors arrive, they should be wearing a mask upon entering the building. You're to report directly to the main office. You'll check in with the secretary. You're going to need a license or other government photo identification to be gone through our Raptor system, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with. Visitors entering the building will be asked to present that license or other government-issued identification. It's going to be scanned, manually entered into the Raptor system by one of our secretaries, and then an adhesive name tag is generated, which you're expected to wear while you are in the building. And we thank you in advance for making sure to adhere to all of our procedures related to visiting the building. At Oswego Middle School, we have three pillars for our students that we live by. We call this our once a buck, always a buck program, and our three pillars are to take care of yourself, take care of others, take care of our school. If we live by those three pillars within our building, then we know that we're doing what's expected, we're showing the respect to each other that is required, we're being safe, and we're being mindful of creating a wonderful environment for us to learn and grow. At Oswego Middle School, we have what we call buck bucks. So when we return to school, students, you will have the opportunity each day to earn buck bucks. And the way that you earn those buck bucks is by being recognized for showing one or more of the three pillars that we live with here at the Oswego Middle School. Our buck bucks can be used at our buck store, which you will see during the virtual tour. And this is where you can purchase school supplies. These can be used during the holiday time to purchase gifts from the buck store for family members and friends. And also once each quarter, students have the opportunity to receive buck bucks in the amount of $5, $10, and $20 worth. And that's related to students that have done their very best in all areas. That's that their attendance has been good. that they have passed all of their classes and have not had any discipline referrals. So that's a wonderful way that students are recognized. They can save up their buck bucks to purchase needed school supplies or just nice little gifts for themselves or others. At this time, a few of our office staff members are going to introduce themselves.
Good morning, new seventh graders. We can't wait to meet you. I'm Mrs. Shelfo. I'm in the main office at the front desk.
And I'm Mrs. Kranz. I'm also in the main office.
And I'm Mrs. Uber, and I work at the back desk in the main office. Can't wait to see you guys.
Can't wait to meet you.
Bye.
Thank you, office ladies. Parents and students, here at the Oswego Middle School, we use Jupiter Ed. This is a wonderful program where students and parents have 24/7 access to the students' grades. All students will receive login information the first week or second week of school that will be sent home. Parents, ask your student for the Jupiter Grades parent information sheet. And then go right on and sign up. You can make it a habit to check your students' grades at least once a week. Please understand that teachers update grades sometimes daily, sometimes every other day, sometimes once a week. So if you see that an assignment is missing, please ask your child if they have submitted that assignment. Give it a day or two and check again. If that assignment has not been updated as having been submitted to their teacher, then we would ask that you email the teacher with any questions you have related to that assignment or any other grades. Many teachers use Jupiter Grades to communicate important information to parents and to students. So this is a wonderful platform for us to stay connected related to students' grades and what's going on in the classroom. At Oswego Middle School, we do have a home and school association that they meet the first Thursday of the month. Those meetings will not resume until school officially reopens. When they are resuming, we will make sure that you will get it in the newsletter and or email blast or phone call. Everyone is welcome. We are fortunate to have a wonderful Home and School Association Board. Our president is Penny Pratt, vice president is Julie Cahill, secretary Kelly Donovan, treasurer Emily Saturnaw. Our seventh grade parent rep is Jen Tice, and our eighth grade parent rep is Tammy Pomatesso. We would like to thank all of these moms for helping out here at the Oswego Middle School. And please, please, once our meetings start, feel free to come. Everyone's welcome. And remember, many hands make light work. At this time, we would like to have our Oswego Library Media Specialist introduce herself.
Hello, Oswego Middle School seventh graders. Welcome to the virtual orientation. My name is Mrs. Steer. I am the Oswego Middle School Librarian. I have many online electronic resources to offer you, as well as many online books that you can borrow for your reading enjoyment. I will be reaching out to you through your Google Classrooms, and you can also connect with me through the Oswego Middle School Library website. Have a great day.
At Oswego Middle School, we do have many clubs. We are so fortunate to have these clubs. The clubs that are listed here are clubs that we feel can still benefit students even during virtual times, and of course we'll continue on once school reopens. We have an awesome art club where Mr. Lee runs that. So if you're interested in any of these clubs, please look for the information related to the clubs. It'll come through on email, may come through on newsletter and email blasts and phone calls. We have our Friend to Friend Club ran by Mrs. O'Dell, Hands-on History Club, which is wonderful. It's run by Mr. Morgan and Mrs. Kingsbury. We have our National Junior Honor Society, which is run by Ms. Royack and Mrs. Brown, Student Council by Mrs. Kingsbury, and Yearbook Club by Mr. Meany. So again, boys and girls, this is if you want to get involved at Oswego Middle School, which we would love for you to do, and to stay connected beyond your typical classes, this is a wonderful way to do so. So look, be on the lookout for more information regarding the Oswego Middle School clubs. So at Oswego Middle School, our students get to begin with Buck Athletics, and it's very exciting. We know that right now things are kind of on hold, but we did receive word as of August 24th that the New York State Public Athletic Association announced certain sports may start on September 21st. More specific information will follow in regards to that and what it looks like for Oswego Buccaneers. Miss Rhonda Bullard is our Director of Physical Education and Athletics. She can be reached via email at rbullard@oswego.org or by calling 315-341-2019. Both the email and phone number are listed here on this slide. If you forget or you don't write it down, please don't hesitate. Just call the middle school and we will get you the information you need. Athletics is a wonderful way for students to build responsibility, respect, sportsmanship. It's a great self-care opportunity. So we really look forward to sports continuing when it is safe. Related to extracurricular activities, we are fortunate here at the Oswego City School District to have the Buccaneer Boosters. The Buccaneer Boosters' mission is to support and promote students, student athletes, coaches, and all of the Oswego City School District sports teams. This is beyond just sports. They have done wonderful things to enhance many of our extracurricular opportunities for students. The president is Mr. Sean Callen, vice president, Mr. Leo Babcock, secretary, Corey Brash, and treasurer, Mr. Eben Norfleet. The meetings are the second Monday of each month. They're in the Oswego cafeteria. All members are welcome. Again, these meetings will resume when school reopens. If you want more information, please go to the below email address at info@buckboosters.com. Join today. Your membership helps the Buck Boosters to make wonderful opportunities possible for our Oswego City School District students. Now comes the time, ladies and gentlemen, where you're going to be able to take a look at some of the places within our Oswego Middle School. You're going to take a virtual tour, and during the virtual tour, you're going to see team hallways. Each student will be assigned to a team. We have a 7 South team, a 7 East team, and a 7 West team. You're also going to see the music hallway, PE hallway in the locker rooms, the cafeteria, our school store where you're able to spend your buck bucks. Remember, once a buck, always a buck. Home and careers and technology classrooms, our career and financial management classroom, our library, our counseling suite, nurse's office, and main office. Now we'll begin our Oswego Middle School virtual guided tour. We would like to thank Mr. Bach and Mr. McCroby for making this possible so that we're able to let our incoming seventh graders and new students take a virtual tour. Without their help, this would not have been possible. So please thank them along with Mrs. Fierro and myself and all of the people at the Oswego Middle School. We look forward to meeting all of you soon and enjoy the virtual tour.
To get started, I thought I would show you the main entrance of the middle school and walk in with you as if you were attending the orientation, which we typically hold in our gym.
This is the main entrance to the building. And when you come in as a seventh grader, you'll enter through these doors every morning and take a right down the main hallway. At this point, I'm going to cut through the main office. This is the main office where you can find me, Mrs. Spaulding, my assistant principal, and some of our secretaries that are going to introduce themselves a little bit later. This is the orchestra room across the hall. And it just so happens, for those orchestra students, Mr. McElroy is here this morning. Mr. McElroy will be joining us this summer, or joining us this fall. The Swiggle Middle School is our new orchestra teacher. If you were attending orientation, you would be walking down this hallway and entering our OMS gym.
If they tell you that you can't, you can shove it in their face.
I can, I can, I can. So
100,000 disbelievers couldn't keep me on the ground. I've invented a momentum that'll never slow me down. I believe it cause I feel it and I shout it out loud.
Yeah.
that.
I can do anything.
Everybody said, boy, don't go anywhere.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
I can do anything. Never push the limit and don't play with fire.
Yes. Yeah.
I can do anything. When my heart on my fist take you by surprise, fire.
Yeah.
I can do anything.
Thank you, everyone. We hope you found our virtual orientation helpful. I hope that you are able to view this again if you have any questions. We had our names and titles and emails up, so feel free to contact us if you have any questions, comments, or concerns. If you do not remember, students, if you do not remember your logon information so that you can log into your Google Classrooms starting on September 14th, please contact our school at 341-2300, and we will need to set up a new password for you. Thank you, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your summer. Don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions, and we look forward to working with you this school year.